So number five in the Transitions Administrator checklist is to update DNS settings for Outlook. Now, as you can see here, this is specifically talking about the DNS autodiscover CNAME or canonical name record. What this really means is that an administrator must go in and create this DNS record for any BPOS tenant or any BPOS domain they own that is a custom domain. So if they have fabricam.com or contoso.com, what have you, and that namespace will be used in the cloud only. So this is not a coexistence type model that all mail is sent and received in the cloud. This record must be created. So what will happen is Outlook is manually configured via the sign-in client in BPOS, manually configured to point to BPOS Exchange Online. Once the transition completes, that manual setting will be removed and Outlook will start looking for this record. So the record needs to be populated so that Outlook can find it and then be able to track down where to connect. So as you can see here, it states to create the CNAME record for autodiscover.yourdomain.com, and that points to autodiscover.outlook.com. Now, I have gone through the transition process, so I'm in GoDaddy right now, and what I've done here is gone in and for the CNAME area, you just do a quick autodiscover under CNAMES, right? And then that will then reference autodiscover.outlook.com. Now, with all of this in play, just hitting save zone file, and of course it's different for one-on-one and all the different DNS registrars out there, or maybe you are an enterprise customer and you run your own DNS servers. This record must be in place, and again, once this is in place, the sign-in client will tell Outlook no longer look for a manual configuration. Outlook tracks down autodiscover.domain.com, determines that it must now talk to autodiscover.outlook.com. Outlook connects to that endpoint, Exchange Online 365, then asks, who are you, username and password, and once authenticated, will direct the Outlook client to then connect to its particular mailbox and complete the process. So as you can see, this is a very, very important step in terms of administration. Because without this, the Outlook client will not be able to determine where to go to connect to that mailbox once it's transitioned into Office 365.